Vayeshev. The portion of Vayeshev opens and begins really the story of Joseph. And Joseph is one of the most interesting and developing and developed personalities in the Bible. Let us take a few moments this time in order to look at the young Joseph, who's 17 years old, and I would say whose personality is not very pleasing. Certainly his father loves him, and his father loves him because he's the first son of Jacob's most beloved wife, Rachel. And Joseph is a very good-looking young boy, and he's a very smart young boy. And for all of these reasons, he gains his father's love. But Joseph is also complicated. His father's favoritism causes him to be fairly isolated amongst his other brothers. And they are jealous of him, and he is jealous of them. In the Talmud, in the tractate Shabbat, page 10, says very clearly, it's forbidden for any parent to favor one child over the other children, because it will lead to family devastation. Let's look at the opening verses. Ele toldot Yaakov, Yosef ben Shvasrei Shana. These are the generations, the children of Jacob, the descendants of Jacob. Yosef was 17 years old. The Bible is telling us without even telling us. The only child who mattered to Jacob was Joseph. Hayaro etechav batzon, literally. He was herding his brothers among the sheep. Joseph saw himself as the father's favorite son. Therefore, he thought he could be the shepherd over his brothers. He could be the boss over his brothers. For Hunar, but he was also young, callow, immature. The Midrash says he spent too much time fixing his hair, coloring his eyes. For Hunar, he was a young man together with Bnei Vilhat, Bnei Zilpan, Shei Aviv. He played with the children of the mistresses, not the children of the major wife, Leah. Because his older brothers, and his more respected and respectable brothers, were not interested in playing with him. And because Yosef is conceited and at the same time jealous, Vayave Yosef eti batam ra'a el aviem, he brought bad stories about his brothers to his father. He was a tattletale. He was a stinker, a snitcher. Nevertheless, the Bible tells us that Jacob, Israel, loved Joseph more than the others and gave him the special garment, the garment which meant the birthright. And that caused the brothers to hate him even more. And Joseph has two dreams. His first dream is of sheaves of corn. And other 11 sheaves bow down to his sheaves. And his brothers are very upset. First of all, because sheaves of corn in agriculture is Egypt, not Israel, which is known for shepherdry. And second of all, Hamaloch timloch aleinu, will you rule over us? Will you be a king over us? Is this the power of your conceit? And they hated him even more. And Joseph has a second dream. with the sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowing down to him. And it's fascinating. He tells this dream also to his father and to his brothers. And the Bible says in verse 10, and his father scolded him and said to him, what kind of dream are you dreaming? Who is the sun and the moon? Your father and your mother? We're all going to bow down to you? But his brothers don't say anything at all. And I would wager that the brothers said among themselves, if that snot-nosed kid is going to have another one of these dreams, supercilious dreams, we're not going to react at all. We're not going to let him hear that we understand that he's dreaming that he's going to be a lord over us. We'll give him the silent treatment. And his father is angry at him. And his brothers are even more jealous of him because he has these megalomaniac dreams of ruling over the entire world. But his father also sees that he has tremendous ambitions, and only people with great ambitions accomplish great things. So here we see Joseph the child, the young, immature teenager, conceited, jealous, many faults, hankering after Egypt and universal control, not very happy in Israel, which seems too small to him. We'll follow the story. We'll see how he develops into a great Jewish leader. And this is also a great lesson for everyone, that even an immature young person can develop into a great leader if he's smart enough to correct his faults and to emphasize his virtues. Shabbat Shalom.